We have got a full garage today, folks. What you looking at? Huh? All right, welcome back, party people. Today, we're gonna talk a little bit about helmets. If you've noticed some of my recent rides, a couple of the riders that have been riding in our group have been riding with these dirt jump slash skate helmets, and it's great for protection. The only problem is the airflow on these types of helmets is fairly restrictive as compared to a good mountain bike helmet that is well vented. And also there's no visor on the front, so when the sun is at the low angles of the day, the visor helps provide a little bit of shade off of your face, and these types of helmets typically don't have those. So I made a decision to go purchase another helmet for our group of riders. Today we're going to talk about two helmets that are in the Bell mountain bike product line, the Bell 4forty, which is considered the all mountain value helmet, and the Bell Sixer, which is considered their top of line trail helmet. And hopefully I can give you some insight and help you make a purchasing decision if you're in the market for a new helmet, and why you may or may not want to purchase the higher end helmet versus the value helmet. So let's get to it. So one of the major factors in my purchasing decision is obviously always price. And the reason I selected Bell in this particular case is because I have somewhat of a pinhead. So I try to get smaller fit helmets, and Bell small seems to fit me better than a lot of helmets. If you have a narrow face or a smaller head, I would suggest looking at Bell helmets. They may be a good option for you. Now the Sixer helmet retails for $170 US, while the 4forty helmet retails for $110 US. So just at an initial glance of both of these helmets, they look very similar on the outside, but there are some major differences if you look at the details of both of these helmets. So let's take a look at the airflow of both of these helmets. So the 4forty is listed at having 15 vents, while the Sixer has 26 vents. Now, I counted the vents on the Sixer, and I'm not sure of the math there, but there are a lot of vents, and I'll show you a neat feature around the brow line of this helmet. Whether they are larger and provide a larger air volume than the actual 4forty, you'll have to make that decision for yourself. I'll probably come back and do a test later this year where we'll take some temperatures of the outer shell of the helmet, the inner shell of the helmet, and also the rider's head to see if there are any major differences. So if we compare the vents on this Sixer, just take a look at the amount of vents on this particular helmet. It does provide good airflow. I have many, many hours on this helmet. This helmet has kept my head pretty cool, so the airflow is pretty good. The thing I like about it the best is these vents over the brows here. They do let some additional airflow come in the front, and not only does it help cool your head, but I also found that it really helps mitigate some of that fogging effect that you may get on your glasses when you ride. And if we come over here and take a look at the 4forty, you'll notice that in the brow line here, there are no additional vents. So that is one difference between the 4forty and the Sixer, which is the brow vents. You can also see that while there are still a lot of vents at 15 on the 4forty, there are a larger number of vents and more cutouts on the Sixer. All right, so if we spin these around and take a look at the vents in the rear of the helmets, you can see that the rear vents are very similar in both helmets here. where you've got this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kind of vents in the back, and you've got the same thing going on the sixer as well. But you can see the difference in the size of the vents. The vent is definitely larger on the sixer versus the 440. Both helmets are MIPS equipped. All right, so now let's take a look at the inside of the helmet and talk a little bit about the padding and the fit system on both helmets. In both of these helmets, the polycarbonate shell is bonded to the EPS foam for a better fit. So take a look at the amount of roll cage material that's in the sixer versus the 440. There's definitely more webbing in the sixer versus the 440. Both helmets have the same snap and adjustment system for the chin strap. And the biggest difference is the fit system that is on the sixer versus the fit system that is on the 440. On the sixer, they call it the race fit system, and it seems to have a layer of padding here on the adjustment. If you can see that, there's a foam layer of padding here on both sides here. Whereas if you look at the fit system on the 440, it is just kind of a hard plastic here. I can't really tell the difference when wearing these helmets, but on extended rides, it may make a difference. It seems like both adjustments are fairly similar. They both have the dial system, which you turn counterclockwise to make larger and clockwise to make smaller. However, on the 440, Bell calls it the float fit system, and on the sixer, they call it the float fit race system. I believe part of that has to do with the extra padding that you get around the back here, and potentially some of the other fitment within the helmet and adjustability. The padding inside the helmet on both of these look very similar, and they feel very similar, so I'm not sure there's a whole lot of difference between the padding on these two helmets. Now, what I can say is that I like both of the pads on these helmets because they have this kind of brow sweat pad here, and it really absorbs any of the brow sweat and some of the sweat that rolls off your forehead when you're riding in hot weather. So I really like that feature of both helmets. All right, so I'll flip both of these helmets back over and I'll start talking about some differences in these helmets, which I think are really what you're paying for when you buy the sixer versus the 440. So I'm gonna take a little bit of time to talk about the visors on both of these helmets and the visor adjustability. So this is the sixer. See how large the visor opening is here between the helmet and the top of the visor? So that visor opens really wide, whereas on the 440, the visor does not open as wide. On the 440, Bell calls this the goggle guide. So this area and space is meant to hold either glasses or your goggles. And similar on the sixer. However, there is a larger space up here on the sixer for goggles. All right, so these are the goggles I typically will ride with, and I kind of share these between some of the motorcycle riding I do and some of the mountain biking. I don't wear goggles a whole lot, so it wasn't a deciding factor for me, but if you do, just take note at how well these large goggles fit between the visor and the front of the helmet, and there is very little overhang down here in the bottom edge of the goggles and the front bottom of the helmet. Nothing to really kind of get in your way or visually there. All right, so take a look at the same goggles on the 440 helmet. Notice how much the goggles overhang over the front lip of the helmet here. And that's probably okay if you're just riding and sometimes you just want to kind of casually store your goggles on your helmet. But if you're riding enduro and you're riding uphill and you want those goggles out of your way, they may get in your field of vision here. So the visor adjustability on the 440, it will not adjust as high as it does on the sixer. So if you're looking for a larger space to fit your goggles on top of your helmet, you definitely may want to go with the sixer versus the 440. Now, the other thing I like more about the sixer helmet versus the 440 helmet, on the sixer helmet, the visor actually has 4 preset adjustments and they're divided by clicks. So lowest, next click, second click, and then highest. Sometimes when you're trying to reach up, you either don't get it right, or the visor either falls down or sags on one side versus the other. So this is a really quick way to just reach up and adjust your visor. So on the 440 helmet, the visor is actually infinite adjustment. So there are no preset clicks on here. So it does make it a little bit more tedious to actually adjust your visor. while you're riding, and sometimes you might lift up on one side more than the other and it gets a little bit crooked on you and it just doesn't look good. But that's one of the main differences between these two helmets is the visor adjustability and the amount of space that they allow for goggles. Now, both of these helmets have little ports cut out that you can easily rest sunglasses on top of. And usually if I'm storing sunglasses on top of my helmet, I am either climbing uphill or I may be taking a break. And these air vents that are on each side here allow to store your sunglasses easily on the helmet. You can also find some vents on the back that you can use, but I find that it's a little bit easier to use the front ones because they spread the end of the glasses out, the earpieces on the glasses out a little bit more, and they don't get in your way when you have the helmet on. So the same goes for the Sixer helmet as well. You can use those side vents to store your glasses above the between the visor and the front of the helmet there. You can also use some of the air ports in the back to store your glasses as well. So both of these helmets provide a great space to store sunglasses. But if you ride with goggles more, you're probably gonna like the opening size of the visor on the Sixer better than the 4forty. All right, again, let's take a look at the rear of each of these helmets. So if you notice on the Sixer, there's a little bit more grip here for your goggle strap, whereas on the 4forty, you get this little one area here. I don't wear a lot of goggles, so I don't know in the long run how that would affect. Just notice that. All right, so one of the other unique features of the Sixer that does not exist on the 4forty is the integrated camera or light breakaway mount system. So on the Sixer, you will get that functionality, and it is just a clip-on system here. So it's breakaway, and this just sits in like such and clips. And now you have your integrated mount system, and it is breakaway, and I have tested this. There's a video back in my playlist where I first kind of did an initial impressions of this helmet. I had a GoPro mounted and I did take a little spill there, and this whole system along with the GoPro actually broke away and probably goes a ways a bit to kind of save your neck, so to speak. That is one feature that the Sixer has that the 4forty does not. Now, when I initially purchased this helmet, I did not purchase it because it had a mount on top for a GoPro camera. That was not my intention. My intention was to purchase this to use a light on the top. I don't like using GoPros on top of the helmet. The point of view that you get from the footage, to me, doesn't work in my particular video scenarios. I would rather have video footage from the angle that a chest mount gives you. But when I ride at nighttime, I do enjoy having this mount on top of the helmet. I wear a light and then one on my handlebars as well. And that gives me a good field of vision and a good light source while night riding. You can still mount GoPros to the 4forty. Obviously, it won't be a breakaway system, but it still has good curvature that fits most of the GoPro sticky mounts here. And you have multiple options where you could actually go on the sides here, or you could go on the center on the top, or further down to the side on the other side. So you have multiple options. So this would be a typical light setup for me on top of the helmet. I really enjoy having this top mount for lights. So that's one thing you'll have to decide for yourself. How much value do you place on having this breakaway mount on top of the helmet, either for a light or for an action camera or other accessories? All right, so let's talk about the other determining factor that may help you in a purchase decision on whether to buy the high-end helmet or the value helmet. And so what we're gonna do is put each of these helmets on the scale. Now, I'm gonna put the Sixer on the scale without its integrated top mount, and we're gonna compare these two as far as weight goes. I will say up front, both of these helmets are a size small for reference there. So let's go ahead and throw the Bell 4forty on the scale here and see what we come up with. All right, so on the Bell 4forty, we're at 12.7 ounces and 360 grams. All right, so now let's weigh the Sixer. And we are coming in at, 14.2 ounces and 402 grams for the Sixer helmet. So this is interesting when we compare the weight. The actual Sixer is heavier in weight, coming in at 14.2 ounces versus 12.7 ounces on the 4forty, which is a difference of 1.5 ounce, and 402 grams on the Sixer, 360 grams on the 4forty, the difference of 42 grams. So the Sixer is actually 42 grams heavier, or 1.5 ounces heavier than the 4forty. All right, so there you have it. So the Sixer actually has more air vents, but is actually heavier than the 4forty. Okay, so in conclusion, which helmet should you purchase if you're in the market for a helmet and you're looking at Bell helmets? The value helmet, the 4forty, or the top of the line helmet, the Sixer? In my opinion, they're both great helmets. I've wore both of these helmets for many hours now. If you're not concerned about price and you're not concerned about weight, then I would say go with the Sixer. You get the integrated camera light accessory mount. You get the larger area for your goggles. You get the extra vents in the helmet along with these brow vents at the front. You also get the larger grip area for your goggle strap in the rear. So those are some of the extra features that you get for that extra $70. So you'll have to make that decision on your own. Hopefully I provided some insight on both of these helmets that will help you make that purchasing decision. All right, party people, that'll do it for this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you did, give me a big thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, make sure you have your post notification enabled. And until next time, you know what to do. Skill up and ride, van up and go, just have fun.